this is not just about getting my daughter or other girls a seat at the table. This is about making the table more inclusive, building a better table, if you will. Unless we change it, it won't happen.
Kimberly Bryant loved math and science as a kid. She was an unapologetic, self-proclaimed nerd. After high school, she studied electrical engineering at Vanderbilt. As excited as she was by all of the innovation happening in her field, she couldn't help but notice that she was one of the few women and the only Black woman in most of her lectures and discussions.
It's really important that there be diversity in that process. Diverse corporations make better decisions and actually make more money. We were thrilled to include you in the book of Gutsy Women because what you did to create Black Girls Code was such a terrific step. And I'd love to know a little bit about how you did it, and also, has it exceeded even your wildest dreams about what it could mean?
It definitely has exceeded my expectations. For me, the journey with Black Girls Code really started with seeing my daughter Kai develop this interest in science and technology, and for the very first time, for her to really show that she might follow my footsteps. She wanted to be so many things until the day she decided she wanted to be an engineer.
Which is what you are.
Which is what I am.
Yeah.
And I saw like how her classrooms were, very much like my classrooms were. I became very concerned because my daughter is my baby. Like she hadn't quite found her voice that way. And I was, and still am, fiercely protective of her and really wanted her dreams to be able to grow. And I didn't feel that in that classroom where she was surrounded by lots of little boys that didn't want her to be a part of what they were doing on the computer, I didn't think that that would necessarily happen. And so I really just started with, you know, an intention that I'm going to take money out of my savings and send five other girls to this camp for coding with Kai for the next summer. And it grew from there.
I think part of what you said, which is so painful to hear, is how little had changed from when you were a student to then seeing how the classroom still looked the same,
right,
a generation later, kind of for your daughter.
Well, the interesting part about it, and somewhat sad part about it as well, is that I remember when I took her to this first summer camp, I did not even really think about the classroom until she said something about how she felt othered or isolated. And then it hit me. I was like, that is just like my college classroom. It really hit me and how much as a society, even myself and having that experience, had become used to a norm that was detrimental to the growth of my own daughter or other daughters. And that really started, you know, the balls like turning in my head about like, well, I just cannot continue.
You know, one of the things that I really feel like you are pioneering with Black Girls Code is making the point that the tech industry, who does that computer coding, it's really important that there be diversity in that process. If we accept that this is how it's always been, this is how it's always going to be, we are doing a great disservice, not only to our girls, but also to our boys and to our society at large.
Absolutely. I think that is the key point, is that this is not just about getting my daughter or other girls and other people of color a seat at the table. This is about making the table more inclusive, building a better table, if you will. And I think that is what is most important about this work, is that it lifts and creates opportunities for everyone to have a different result. If it's, unless we change it, it won't happen.
As the Black Girls Code graduates go through college, graduate school, and their careers, the world will see what they build, create, and then help others imagine.
I think the research certainly shows that more diverse teams and teams that have more women in leadership roles and in the boardroom are more successful. Mm-hmm. And so I think one of the things that we're trying to do is just make sure that our girls have skills so that they're ready. Mm-hmm. So like I'm from the South, we say if you stay ready, you don't have to get ready. So my goal is to make sure they're ready to take part in the industry when those opportunities and those doors open. One of the things that we've always said within BGC is that we see tech as just a tool. It's just a tool. And The girls that come through our program can use that for whatever. They can become a doctor. Many of them are in the field of medicine. They can go into biotech. They can become a leader like yourself. And this is just another tool in their toolkit. And we want them to see it that way, but not limit themselves to just one thing, because that's where we feel that there is the greatest power.